5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Starting with this civil procedure court, I'll first of all tell you what are the problems with the students. So we identify few problems in CPC, especially in CPC. As you generally say, the first problem is, I am starting with problem because understanding of problem is the first problem. And if you understand the problem, half of the problem is solved. So let us understand the problem. And as many as problem there are, you will share with me and I'll tell you the solution. My job is to give you solutions of everything which is possible on this earth regarding this subject. So first problem, you said problem of memorization of sections. Similarly, I write problem of memorization of orders, memorization of rules. So these are all related to this. The second problem which you said, many of you might have faced or you will be facing. The problem of understanding the stages or the steps, I'm adding it from my side. Stages or steps of civil procedure, how it moves. This will be the discussion point in today's class. Stages or steps of civil procedure, because we are not in court, we are in class, and even then we are required to understand this. What are different stages or steps of civil procedure? I will let you know. Then the third problem, as we are preparing for exam of judicial services. So the third problem comes, problem of answering the question. Now many people have many problems, as I have been discussing with the thousands and lakhs of students. They have shared their idea and they say that we have problem even in objective questions to identify the correct option, because we'll get very similar or very near options. I'll tell you how to do it. And then subjective questions. Now in subjective questions, there is problem of how much content, what kind of concept, understanding of question is must, content and concept, and rules, all right. Anything else? I'll discuss that also, don't worry. Kuch aur sawal hai to bataiye. But they cannot teach you all answers, and one answer is also not sure. I tell you, this is their individual things they have written, but that is not advisable at all. I seriously not recommend it. So don't think for answers. Answers are there in your notebook. ये copy किस लिए लाए हैं आप? ये answers ही तो लिखेगा सारे. मैं लिखाऊंगा आपको answer. You ask me question in class, I'll give you answer in class. I will not run away. But you should be prepared. You ask any question from the book or from anywhere on this universe, I am prepared to answer here in the class. I will answer it in the class. I don't need any book. I don't need any guide. Otherwise, why I am here? Why you are here? I will answer, I promise you. You ask me, I'll give you what is content of answer. Tum woh nahi likhoge, woh bhi bataunga. Let us come to the point. So your question is again added, revision, relations between orders, sections and rules. Is this clear? Any other question, please? How do you remember cases? By applying my mind, I will tell you. How do you remember my name? Tell me. बताऊं मैं अभी छोड़ दो मैं बताऊं एक चीज. हम लोग ना बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन ना स्पेकुलेट करते हैं, हाइपोथेसाइज करते हैं. दैट इज नॉट करेक्ट. आई विल टेल यू हाउ टू रिमेंबर. आप यदि किसी प्री कंसीव, देखो आपकी जो ट्रेनिंग है ना वो डिफरेंट है. मेरी जो मैं जो आपको ट्रेनिंग दूंगा वो डिफरेंट है. If you forget everything, whatever you have learned, that will be better. I don't remember anything. Everything. Without using this. Chalo, tumhare liye isko idhar rakh dete. Ye na kok sir ne beech mein dekh liya hoga halke se. Have confidence in yourself. Sabse pehle you start with yourself. I can do it, I will do it, I must do it. Pehle apne mein confidence hona chahiye. For you, problem number one was memorization of this thing, section, orders, rules. Problem number two, I said, I have identified this problem for you, stages or steps of simple procedure. Problem number three is answering question. I said objective, subjective. In subjective content and concept, that was the question of hers. Then I said judgment, pleading, summons. Now, this kind of pattern is coming right now. Even in criminal procedure, this kind of questions is coming. How do you issue warrant? You might not have read warrant kaise issue karte. Aapko sawal pucha, giraftari ka warrant kaise issue karoge batao. Kaise likhte ho batao. So you should know contents of warrant and there is format, you should learn that. When you read this, you will learn it. There is nothing to memorize even in this, I tell you. I'll make you remember, don't worry. I'll give you some glimpses here in the first lecture itself. So these are the problems. Then you said revision at the time of exam and relations, this will come this way. Tell me, we are going to study the CPC. What is CPC? Civil Procedure Code. So this prescribes a civil procedure for trial of civil cases. It's very simple. You are not required to refer to any book. Whatever I'll speak, that will be common sense. Now what will you do if you have a civil wrong against you and you want a remedy? Kya karoge? Kya kya sawal aapke man mein aayega? What kind of questions will come to your mind? First question will be, whether it's a civil wrong against me or not, kaise pata kare? Aapko lag raha hai problem hai, wrong hai, but aap uske liye kya karoge batao? Aap uske concerned law mein jaoge, dekhoge. Se tort wrong hai mere khilaf ya kisi ne breach of contract kiya to main zarur dekhunga ek bar ki sahab contract mein kya aisa koi breach hota hai and is there any remedy for it. Similarly in tort I will go and I will visit tort law and I will see whether there is a tort wrong or not against me. Isko hum log kya kehte hain legal language mein pata hai aapko? Cause of action. First you should have cause of action and there is cause behind every action. This is not legal. If you have come here, there is a cause behind it. You want to excel in judicial services examination. That is the cause. Or you want to learn civil procedure, even if you are practicing. You want to know the basics. There is cause. So if you want action from the court, you should have a cause. And that is what is called the cause of action. So you have to show that, look, as we go to pleadings, pleadings is plaint for plaintiff and WS for defendant. आप जानते होंगे civil procedure में there are two kind of parties. एक को कहते हैं plaintiff, दूसरे को कहते हैं defendant. Plaintiff is aggrieved party. He writes a plaint. He goes to court and he asks for remedy against a defendant. This is very simple. So there will be two sides in any case. Is this clear? So what plaintiff has to show in his plaint? क्या दिखाएगा वो? Cause of, and if there is no cause of action, there can be no plaint. It will be rejected. So plaint has a ground of rejection. See, it's how simple. It's commonsensical. Isko hum log baith ke ratenge. Rejection ke kya kya ground hai. No, we are not required to remember. We are required to understand. And that is what is problem in methodology of learning and understanding. And that is why all these questions. मैं आपको बताऊंगा अभी सीपीसी याद करना कितना सरल है. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. विच लुक्स हरकुलियन फॉर यू, इट्स वेरी सिंपल टास्क फॉर मी बिकॉज आई एम नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू रिमेंबर. आई अंडरस्टैंड सीपीसी. यू अंडरस्टैंड, यू रिमेंबर. सो आई सेड यू विल गो टू कोर्ट विद कॉज एंड देन द कोर्ट विल इनिशिएट एक्शन. नाउ द मोमेंट यू मूव, नाउ सिविल प्रोसीजर स्टार्ट्स हियर. नाउ यू सी, your CPC is divided in two parts, sections and orders. Sabko pata hai. 158 sections are there. चूंकि आप याद नहीं करते हो तो देयर मे बी सम काइंड ऑफ रॉन्ग ऑल्सो ऑन योर पार्ट, जस्ट यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू वेरीफाई. एंड देयर आर हाउ मेनी ऑर्डर्स? 51 ऑर्डर्स. अब सेक्शंस एंड ऑर्डर्स का क्या रिलेशन है? पहले तो पढ़ने का तरीका सीख लेना ध्यान से. मैं आपको बताता हूं, बहुत आसान है. वॉट एवर यू हैव रिटन इन सेक्शंस, हाउ दैट विल बी ब्रॉट इन फोर्स, दैट इज रिटन इन ऑर्डर. फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, द मोमेंट यू हैव प्लान्ड टू फाइल ए केस इन द कोर्ट, देयर विल बी सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस व्हिच विल अराइज इन योर माइंड. Which court to visit? कौन से कोर्ट में जाएंगे? तो सवाल का जवाब मिला, the court which has territorial jurisdiction, the court which has pecuniary jurisdiction, the court which has subject matter jurisdiction. Very simple. I am initiating the process of civil procedure. I want to file a suit. सूट कहते हैं उसको. मैं सब चीज की व्याख्या देता रहूंगा बीच बीच में, बट जस्ट हैव पेशेंस, लिसन टू मी केयरफुली. आई मे नॉट एक्सप्लेन सर्टेन वर्ड्स राइट नाउ, बट आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट लेटर ऑन. सो व्हाट आई सेड, व्हेन यू प्लान टू विजिट अ सिविल कोर्ट, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस विल कम इन योर माइंड? तो सबसे पहला सवाल तो आएगा, अच्छा मैं करूंगा केस किसके खिलाफ? तो जिसने मेरे खिलाफ रॉन्ग किया, जिसको आप डिफेंडेंट कहते हो. तो पहला प्रश्न उठेगा पार्टीज. अच्छा जी, पार्टीज के खिलाफ केस करोगे? देखो ऑर्डर्स भी ऐसे ही लिखा है, मैं आपको भी बताऊंगा, डोंट वरी. दूसरा सवाल क्या आया मन में, विच कोर्ट टू विजिट? तो आई सेड देयर विल बी थ्री सब क्वेश्चंस. पहला क्वेश्चन आएगा टेरिटोरियल ज्यूरिसडिक्शन. इफ द रॉन्ग हैज हैपेंड इन दिल्ली, विल यू गो टू बैंगलोर? Generally, no. Common sense की बात कर रहा हूं without going into nitty-gritties. If the wrong has happened in Delhi, will you go to Bangalore? Tell me. You will not. Territorial jurisdiction कहते हैं. If it is a very insignificant, trivial wrong, will you go to highest court? No. So you start with lowest court. This is what is written in section 15 of CPC. I'll tell you how to remember. Section 15 मैंने तो बोल दिया आपको, ध्यान होगा नहीं, बट उसका तरीका है मैं बताऊंगा.
तीन सवाल है,
सब्जेक्ट मैटर jurisdiction, pecuniary jurisdiction, territorial jurisdiction. बहुत सिंपल है. सब्जेक्ट मैटर jurisdiction, pecuniary jurisdiction एंड territorial jurisdiction. क्यों मैं बताऊं? देखो अब फिर ये नहीं मैं कह रहा हूं कि आप रटना इसको बैठ के, आपको समझना है क्यों ये तीन ज्यूरिसडिक्शन. भाई रट लू बैठ के, ऐसे ही हम पढ़ते रहे हैं. हमारी शिक्षा व्यवस्था बड़ी थोड़ी डिफरेंट टाइप की, हमको ऐसे ही पढ़ाया जाता है. सी देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ माउंटेन्स, देर आर दिस व्हाट एवर इट इज, हमें ऐसे ही पढ़ाया गया है. वी हैव नेवर बीन गिवन रीजन व्हाई दीज आर थ्री टाइप्स. भाई क्या क्या सवाल उठेगा तुम्हें बता दो. क्राइम यहां हुआ या कोई रॉन्ग यहां हुआ तो कहां की कोर्ट ट्रायल करे? यहां की. तो उसको हमने टेरिटोरियल ज्यूरिसडिक्शन का नाम दे दिया. मामला छोटा है तो बहुत बड़े कोर्ट में जाओगे, दिस इज नॉट फेयर. उसको हमने पिक्यूनरी ज्यूरिस, क्योंकि सिविल मैटर है, इसमें पिक्यूनरी थिंग्स आएंगे, सब चीज का वैल्यूएशन होगा. हम प्रॉपर्टी के बारे में सूट फाइल कर रहे हैं, हम टॉर्ट में भी सूट फाइल कर रहे हैं. ऑब्वियसली व्हाट इज योर अल्टीमेट एंड? You will be claiming certain damages. Generally तो यही होता है tort law में. आप फिर pecuniary पे आ गए, आप फिर pecuniary पे आ गए. Breach of contract you will claim damages, फिर pecuniary पे आ गए. अब ध्यान दो, मैं आपको कह रहा हूं मेरा submission बहुत simple है, आप पढ़ने की प्रक्रिया ही बदल दो. You switch the method of learning. It's not so easy. For that you will have to train yourself for month and year. It will not come in one day. Inertia is there. मैं आज आपको बताऊंगा, कल आप भूल जाओगे. It's proven. But if you will be with me for a long time, you will learn the methods very easily. You will imbibe this, and I have done it. Then I said third thing, subject matter. If it's a civil matter, will I go to criminal court? इसको ही तो subject matter कहते हैं. Civil है, criminal है, क्या है बताओ? ये लॉ की क्लास है तो मैं लॉ पढ़ाऊंगा आपको, हिस्ट्री पढ़ाऊंगा. आई मे हैव इंटरेस्ट इन हिस्ट्री, बट विल आई टीच यू हिस्ट्री? द आंसर इज नो. दिस इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड सब्जेक्ट मैटर. हमने कहा थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ ज्यूरिसडिक्शंस आर देयर. सब्जेक्ट मैटर सेक्शन 9, ऑल सिविल सूट्स पढ़ा होगा आपने शायद. पिक्यूनरी ज्यूरिसडिक्शन सेक्शन 6 एंड टेरिटोरियल ज्यूरिसडिक्शन सेक्शन 15-20. हाउ टू रिमेंबर दिस आई विल लेट यू नो. अभी उस पर नहीं जा रहे, अरेंजमेंट पे भी नहीं है. मैंने कहा द मोमेंट यू थिंक ऑफ फाइलिंग सिविल सूट, दिस प्राइमरी क्वेश्चन, प्रिलिमिनरी क्वेश्चन नाउ विल अराइज इन योर माइंड, एंड दिस इज हाउ सीपीसी स्टार्ट्स. अब हम इतनी छोटी सी बात से यदि स्टार्ट करें तो हमें सब कुछ समझ में आता है. ये भी समझ में आएगा, ये भी सारे समझ में आएंगे. यदि हम इतनी छोटी बात को छोड़ देंगे, नाइदर आई विल रिमेंबर दिस नॉर आई विल अंडरस्टैंड दिस. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. अभी इस पे बाद में आएंगे, बिकॉज आंसरिंग क्वेश्चंस विल कम व्हेन यू रीड लिटिल बिट. सो नाउ अब आपकी जो समस्या है मैं उस पर धीरे धीरे बात भी करूंगा. आपने कहा मेमोराइजेशन इज अ रियल प्रॉब्लम. नाउ व्हाइल अंडरस्टैंडिंग द होल सीपीसी विल डिस्कस दैट एज वेल. सो आई स्टार्टेड विद दिस प्रमाइज, सीपीसी प्रेस्क्राइब्स सिविल प्रोसीजर एंड व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस सिविल प्रोसीजर, टू एड्रेस ए रॉन्ग एंड टू प्रोवाइड ए रेमेडी. सो फर्स्ट वी आइडेंटिफाइड द रॉन्ग, देन वी आइडेंटिफाइड द कोर्ट, देन वी आइडेंटिफाइड द पार्टीज, and then we'll identify the remedy, and I will convince the court that see, this wrong has been committed against me, this is the remedy available for me, and this remedy can be provided by you, and there is cause of action, so you please provide me remedy. And that is how a plaint is written. Aapko ratna nahi hai. The moment you start mugging up things, you will create problem for yourself. Order 7 padha hoga kabhi, jante hoge, nahi jante ho chhodo, main bata raha hu. इट इज ऑर्डर 7, रूल 1. अब आप कहोगे साहब अब देखो रूल भी आ गया, मैं कैसे याद रखूंगा? मैं आपको बताऊंगा मेथड्स. मैं आपको बहुत सिंपल मेथड बताता हूं, पहले धीरे धीरे बताते हैं आपको. जब भी हम कहीं कोई रेमेडी लेने जाएंगे तो सबसे पहले मैं, आई एम द अग्रीव्ड पार्टी, यू आर द रॉन्ग डूअर फॉर ए सेकेंड. मैं किसके खिलाफ जाऊंगा? आपके खिलाफ. इसी को कहते हैं पार्टीज. देखो कितना आसान है. तो कोई चीज दिमाग में बिठा लो अच्छे से, बहुत सिंपल बात बता रहे हैं. दिस हेड विल बी ऑलवेज हियर एंड दिस टो विल बी ऑलवेज देयर. कोई आपने बॉडी देखी है, ह्यूमन बॉडी जिसमें टो इज दिस साइड एंड हेड इज दैट साइड? हैव यू सीन इट? सिमिलरली सीपीसी इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड. The moment you understand this skeleton of CPC, you are not required to remember. Until the point you don't understand it, whether you read Mullah or Takwani or for that matter T.P. Tripathi or any other book, you will never understand and never memorize. I am not citing other books, Dukkis etc. They do not stand in the queue. They are secondary kind of books. They can never make you learn things better. They can just pass facts and informations. Passing facts and information is very easy. Anybody can do. Even you can do this in CPC. You can give all facts. But understanding has to be built. That is what is this class all about. So I said, parties will start this process. अच्छा क्या करोगे? क्या करते हो? क्या लेके जाओगे कोर्ट में? तो तुमने कहा जी हम एक सूट बनाएंगे. वही तो लेके जाओगे. तो दूसरा जो है ना, हमने ऑर्डर में लिखा, हम नहीं लिख रहे हैं, ये तो लॉजिक कह रहा है. क्या लेके जाओगे? सूट. पार्टीज क्या लेके जाएगी? आपने सीपीसी पढ़ा तो होगा, या नहीं पढ़ा है तो जानते होगे. यू माइट बी अवेयर, यू माइट हैव हर्ड. Can you straightway go to civil court and can file case? No. You must have seen there is pleader sign also in your pleadings. And if you don't know, you know it. So who will do it? Who will do it? the pleaders, the agents, advocates. Now, can you see order 3? What is written there? Recognized agents and मैं नहीं बता रहा हूं, ये आप बता रहे हो, देखो हमने नहीं बताया, आप ही कह रहे हो. Recognized agents and because you cannot go to court straight away. So the things which looks very difficult to you, I think it should look very simple to you. It should be very simple to you. And you know what this agents or pleaders will do? I tell you, they will institute suit in court. You cannot do it. Abhi aapko dikhaunga, rules are written. So order 4. I am not doing anything. It's happening. The head is there. The soldier is here. The chest is here. You cannot change this. The stomach is here. You cannot change this. There is no possibility of change and there is no authority of change. It's written like this. It has to be written like this. I can't change this order. Only thing is, you have to understand, the moment suit is instituted, I have instituted the suit in court, what the court will do? Court will call the other party. We they go, there is a suit against you. You please come and answer it. Then I will proceed further. So, what comes next? What comes next? Issue of process. We issue process. That is what is called summons. You have said correctly. You have said correctly. Order. Now, when you institute suit or when you frame suit and when now summons has been issued, both parties are before the court because you have come to the court and they have now come to the court after issuance of process or summons. Is this clear? Now both parties have their own submissions. Now law says how they will write their own submissions. So there is a rule for that, for writing their submissions. You cannot write everything. Many affairs are formal. Many affairs are formal. It's not informal. If I ask you to come for a cup of tea, it's informal. But when I ask you to come to my class, it's formal. You're not my guest. I'm not host. I'm your teacher. You are my student. But outside class, it may be a different thing altogether. So it's a formal affair. We have to be careful. Same here. You cannot write anything anyway. Oh, mujhe plant likhna hai, main to kisi tarah se likh dunga. No, you can't do this. You have to follow the rules. Because see, I tell you, here is why we are required to follow the rule. It's very important. Because see, in any procedural law, the core concern of law is that there should be speedy trial and fair trial. What I said, there should be a speedy and fair trial. A speedy and fair trial. If this is so, we will try to do those things which will not hamper speed and which will maintain fairness in trial process. How will you do it? Kaise karoge? So when you write plaint, you write relevant things. And when you write your answer, the defendant will come to the court after issuance of process, order 5. He has to also write relevant things. You cannot write irrelevant. He cannot write irrelevant. So how will you do it? It's very simple. We'll follow the rules of pleading. We'll follow the rules of pleading. And what is the rules of pleading? There are many rules of pleading, but I'll let you know in very brief. What sankshep mein aapko pleading ka rule batate hain, what sankshep mein. And what is the rule? Write relevant, don't write irrelevant. Write material facts, don't write immaterial facts. Don't write evidentiary facts. मतलब कहने का यही है कि you have to save time of the other party, you have to save time of the court, and you have to save your own time. You write everything in the pleading which you want to write. Generally, pleading में क्या लिखेंगे? आप ही बता दो, छोड़ो मैं rules of pleading नहीं जानता. Let us talk common sense. I don't know rules of pleading. I have never read Order 6. I don't know of Order 6. I ask you a very simple question. If you go to court with a prayer, I want relief from the Lordship, what will you say to the court? That see, these are the facts. On the basis of this, this wrong has been done to me, and there is remedy for it. So please provide me that remedy. As a plaintiff, you will write this. So aap kya kya likh rahe ho? Facts. Facts. You are showing cause of action. And then you are asking for a remedy and relief. So these are the three main components of your plaint. Kuch bhi nahi karna hai, bahut dhyan se meri baat sunna hai. Bahut aasan hai ye to. Acha, facts mein kya likh dun? Once upon a time I was born in the city of Allahabad. Who is asking you this? You write relevant thing. Right material fact, because you are required to show cause of action. So where cause arose, how cause arose, you tell me that. So I will say, there was a contract between you and me. According to contract, I did this, and according to contract, you did not do this. And that is how you breached the contract. And here is a cause of action. So I seek remedy of damages from the court. I am saying it very plainly. You will write it legally later on. But this is just for understanding. Facts, cause, a remedy, relief. That is very simple. Written statement mein, what you will write in defense? Aap to har cheez ko deny karoge. Aap to deny karoge na, it's defendant. Defendant has got this task. It's very simple again. It's very simple. If there is a contract which you cannot deny, so you will admit the contract. But you will deny it on other basis. You will deny it on other basis. Is this clear? Aap kahoge, yes, there was a contract. But I did not breach the contract, the defendant says. It was breached by the other party. How? He was not ready and willing to do his entire part, so I did not perform my part. So he is breaching the contract, I am not breaching the contract. So what defendant does? He prepares his defense, and that is again called pleading. So he will also write the relevant things, relevant facts, where he will either admit or deny. He may admit the contract, but he may deny the fact that I breached the contract. And that is how WS is written. Aap dekho, if you can remember your school days, when you were in the habit of complain every time, how do you complain to the authorities? Aap kya kya batate the jaake socho jada. Sir, usne aisa kya, usne aisa kya, usne aisa kya. Sir ne pucha, tumne kya kya? Humne sir kuch nahi kya. Wo galat kya. Usko sir saja do. Usko class se bahar karo. Something like that. Now he will call the other party. The principal will call the other party. And he will ask him, what is the fact? Tell me. So he will tell his own version. I did this, I did this. He did this. Whatever. I did not do anything wrong. And when he did this, I did it in reaction. So where I am wrong? So how can he seek remedy against me? So I am not liable to punishment. That is how you defend yourself. This is how simply we write WS. But in writing of Plant and WS, in both cases, we follow the rules of pleading. And I told you, you are required to remember three things. You have to show facts, the material one. You have to show how cause of action arose. And you have to show that there is remedy. Aap dekh lena, koi bhi plant utha ke, where there may be number of points written in it. You will write these three things primarily. Facts, cause of action, remedy and relief. This is as simple as that. Itna hi saral hai. Is this clear? This is as simple as that, I tell you. Kuch bhi nahi karna aapko. So now, before proceeding further, CPC provides that, see, I have to save the time of the court, of the parties. So, what CPC does? It says that you have to follow the rules of pleadings. That is what is called itna saral hai. And pleadings for plaintiff is called plant. First, ab batao. Ab tumhi ko ye pooch raha hu. I ask a very simple question. First, you will write the pleadings of plaintiff or you will write pleadings of defendant. Tell me. So why do you say I don't remember? Rather, you should put it like this. I never tried to understand it. That is correct version. You never tried to understand it. I tell you, even in order when there are rules, it may be 106 rules of 21, there is an organization in those rules. If you understand the organization, you understand how these rules are written. And mostly you will remember what is written where. But the problem will be this, that whether you will understand the organization or not, whether you have been able to understand the organization or not. I have never seen somebody's leg here and somebody's hand here. I have never seen in my life. So that is like this. CPC is like this. So after plant only WS will come. I am not required to remember. I am required to understand it. I have never understood. That's my problem. Now, see, it's very simple again. Everybody understands English? No issue? And everybody understands Hindi also? Anybody who doesn't understand Hindi? Everybody understands Hindi? All right. See, language is for communication. If language becomes barrier of communication, we should adopt that language which can communicate better. I remember a teacher was speaking in Sri Lanka and he was speaking in Hindi. And many people said, first, I could not understand what you said in Hindi. But later on, they were praising all Hindi. They said, we are now understanding what are you saying. The teacher was communicative, effective communicator. He was a very good orator. What I said, pleading plant for plaintiff and WS for defendant. Now, when you have filed your submissions, I have given my submission, you gave your submission, the court will call both the parties, bhai tum aao humare samne and batao what is the point. So we write, appearance, non-appearance. I have written in brief. Appearance, non-appearance. Then I have called you not to stand there in the court. I will examine you. So, order 10 is examination. Just suppose you have given your submissions. I have examined you also. But the parties cannot understand each other's case clearly. Or maybe even court does not understand it. Will you not ask for further things to be submitted? The answer is yes. That is why we have order 11, order 12, order 30. I am asking for further things. Order 11 talks of discovery and inspection. I could not understand this. Discovery means discovery of new fact. Discovery of document. I could not, you have referred a document, but I could not know what this document exactly says. So please give me the document, I want to see it. You have written so many things, I could not understand what you have written. So these are the questions that is called interrogatory in the language of law. So we issue interrogatories. So discovery and inspection. We are further trying to discover and inspect the case of opponent. And even the court will be interested in this. Because court has to frame issue, so court has to understand the case. When you do not understand the question, do you ask further things or not? Similarly, the court and the parties can do it. They can ask further question. Plaint has been submitted. WS has been submitted. WS has been given to plaintiff. Plaintiff has been given WS. And defendant has been given plaint. But they do not understand what is exactly in the plaint. There may be many gaps. So now they have been called. They have been examined in order 10. Order 10 is examination. Even then we could not understand. So we are adopting other methods. Order 11, discovery and inspection, you can write down. So I said, order 10. See, we are trying to understand the steps in civil procedure as well. This is the step, and that is how CPC is written. Who says CPC is difficult? It is one of the easiest subject, but we make it difficult. Now see, you examined the parties in order 10, but you could not understand the opponent's case. So what we did, we asked for further supply of facts. That is what is called discovery, either by interrogatories or by production of some documents, materials, admissions. There may be many things in your WS which might have admitted my case. Like I said, there was a contract between you and me which you have breached. So now you can admit the contract, but you can deny the breach. So contract is not required to be proved because you have admitted. And if you are not aware, let me inform you, evidence law says, evidence law says, the facts admitted need not be proved. If you have admitted, why should I prove it? I say that there was a contract between me and you. And you say, yes, there was a contract. So, am I required to prove it before the court? Why to waste time? I said, we are all required to make process for a speedy and fair trial. So, this is how we can maintain speed. This is how we can maintain the speed. Is this clear? This is how we can maintain the speed. And that is how we can make the things fair also. If the fact which I am averring and you are accepting, where is the requirement of proof? If I say yes, you say no, then there is a requirement of proof. It is a universal rule. If you confess the crime, am I required to prove always? If the court asks me to prove, that's a different matter. But if you confess the crime, why should I prove it? You have already admitted the guilt. So this is as simple as that. Confession can be the basis of conviction. Similarly, here, admission can be the basis of proof of this particular fact that there was a contract between you and me. There is no requirement of further proof. So this is how I can save the time of the system, and that is what Order 12 does. Production and impounding of documents. But you need further documents. You need further documents for that purpose. Now, this is basically preparation. This is all for the settlement of issues. Now, jaise criminal code mein aap charge banate hain. On the basis of police report or on the basis of complaint, aap charge likhte hain na. Ki bhai inke khilaf ye charge lagaya jata hai. Inhone chori ki, inhone murder kiya, whatever. So you charge him under section 302 or under section 379. Oh, all right. So similarly, here in civil cases, we prepare issues. I am saying there is a contract. You are saying there is no contract. So now there is issue. Whether there was a contract between A and B or not. I say that I did my part. You did not perform your part. So there is an issue. Who breached the contract? So that is how we are settling the issues. And that is what is Order 14. Court will do it. They will settle the issue of fact, settle the issue of law. We'll read this later on. But this is how the organization is written. How the organization is there in civil procedure court. And now, when the issues are settled, then the court will apply its mind. And if court finds that there is nothing to be proved, all facts are admitted, then in Order 14 it says, on the first day itself we'll decide the case. Order 15, that is how I can save the time. First day itself. As simple as that. If it is not done, then we will call the witnesses. Order 16. But there may be requirement of waiting and watching. There may be non-availability of certain people, certain things, or I may be required to give time to other party for certain reasons. Because in trial process, there can be many hindrances also. Somebody may die. The lawyer is so ill that he cannot be called to the court. The plaintiff is not prepared with evidence. The defendant is not prepared with evidence due to some reason beyond their control. So what can you do? Adjournment. Order 17. In between you will find certain additions also, like 16A, there is an addition. If you want to call witness from prison, 16A provides the method. This is as simple as that, you are not required to worry. Order 18. Now, what will be the order of examination and production of evidence? Generally, if I am saying something, I will prove it. If you are saying something, you will prove it. Onus of proof on plaintiff, onus of proof on defendant. I'll tell you how it is written when we settle issue. OPP, OPD. Ab ye to bhi aapko main bata raha hun, sprinklers hain. You will have to go in detail. It's not so simple as it looks like. You are required to study in great detail. Because you cannot work only with the orders, numbers. You are required to remember even the rules. But the same formula will come handy there as well. But it will take time. So now, Order 18 deals with evidence, examination of the parties. Trial process has begun. After settlement of issues, trial process has begun. After charge framing, you start trial in criminal cases. After issue framing, you start trial in civil process. Is this clear? To save time, we give evidence by affidavit. Court will allow you to give evidence by affidavit, and how evidence is given by affidavit, that is written in Order 19. Now, when you are prepared with all this, Order 20, you can give judgment. trial has begun and trial has ended. Now, when judgment is given, then we impose cost on one party or the other party because it's a civil case, it's private wrong, so state will not bear the cost. That is why we are required to pay the court fees, that is why we are required to pay the cost as well of the suit. So who will bear the cost? Order 20A. Addition is there. And once order is given, judgment is given, then there is question of execution of that judgment, that order, that decree. So how execution of decree takes place, that is order 21. And this is how civil procedure moves. This order 1 to 21 is the beginning of the process and the end of the process. Ab aapko ke baki jo hai ye orders kya karenge wo bhi batata hu. But can you remember this order 1 to 21 first of all? That is my question. Yes or no?
Yes,
it's so simple. It's like head to toe. We party jayegi, suit leke jayegi, wakil sahab ko pakadegi, wakil sahab institute karenge suit, jaise hi suit institute hoga, dusri party ko bulayenge, aur kaise likhoge tum apna plant aur WS, order 6 mein batayenge, 7 mein tum plant likh ke le jana, 8 mein wo likh ke laayega. Jab dono likh ke laoge, to 9 mein dono party ko court bulayegi. 10 mein dono se court poochtaach karegi. If they are not convinced, they will ask for further things. That is order 11, Adesh Sankhya 11, 12, 13. Isko Adesh kehte hai Hindi mein. Rule ko niyam kehte hai. Plaintiff ko vadi kehte hai. Defendant ko prativadi kehte hai. Is this clear? कभी कभी बच्चे जज बन के चले आते हैं. एक बार राजस्थान में ऐसे बात, और वहां वकील साहब शुद्ध हिंदी में बोलते हैं. जज साहब समझ ही नहीं पाते हैं क्या बोल रहा है ये. अधिवक्ता महोदय का कथन आपकी समझ से परे हो जाता है, और जब ऐसा हो जाता है न्यायाधीश महोदय, तो न्याय का निर्धारण बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है. इसलिए मेरी आपको सलाह होगी कि हिंदी के शब्दों से अपने आप को जरूर रूबरू कराए, अन्यथा आपको न्यायालय में समस्याओं का सामना करना पड़ेगा. आपको मेरी बात समझ में आ रही है? इफ यू गो टू कोर्ट्स लाइक राजस्थान, छत्तीसगढ़, एमपी, यूपी, बिहार, हिंदी स्पीकिंग स्टेट्स, इवन गुजरात, यू विल फाइंड लेस यूज ऑफ इंग्लिश, स्पेशली इन ट्रायल कोर्ट्स. सो बी केयरफुल. इवन इन दिल्ली दे विल कम विद some kind of language which may not be known to you, which is Punjabi. So yahan to seekh jaoge, koi badi baat nahi hai, English bhi bol lete hain, but states mein thodi si samasya hogi. So dhyan rakhna iska, thodi modi hindi bhi tumhe aani chahiye. Aisa na ho aap bilkul hindi mein sifar ho. Sifar ka matlab shunya hota hai. Chaliye aage le chalte hain abhi aapko. पहले मैं ऑर्डर 1 टू 20 जो इधर बताया, मैं उसका आपको सेक्शंस भी इधर बताता हूं. देखो, यू विल फाइंड इट ब्यूटिफुल. व्हेन एवर आई सी सीपीसी, माय हार्ट इज ग्लैडेंड विद दिस अरेंजमेंट. आई फील रियली गुड अबाउट इट. स्टूडेंट्स फील बैड अबाउट इट एंड आई फील वेरी गुड अबाउट इट. आई फील हैप्पी व्हेन आई टीच सीपीसी, क्योंकि मुझे तो थोड़ी बहुत समझ में आती है. ज्यादा कर तो मैं भी कोई दम्भ नहीं भरूंगा, बिकॉज दैट इज टू बैड. नॉलेज इज इनफाइनाइट. आई हैव लिमिटेड नॉलेज, बट आई हैव सो मच नॉलेज दैट आई कैन आंसर ऑल योर क्वेश्चंस. जनरली देयर इज ए राइटर एज वेल. सो लेट मी टेक यू टू सेक्शंस. आपने भी पूछा था ना, हाउ सेक्शंस एंड ऑर्डर्स. दिस इज अनदर प्रॉब्लम. कुछ भी नहीं है. तुम सीपीसी का बैरेक्ट निकालो, खुद से देखो, तुम्हें फिर ऐसा ही एक अरेंजमेंट वहां दिख रहा है. मुझे तो दिख रहा है, तुम्हें दिख रहा है? नहीं दिख रहा है. देखो, मैं तो बिना किताब के भी देख ले रहा हूं. सेक्शन 1 जनरली इंट्रोडक्शन होता है. जैसे कहीं जाते हो ना, अपना परिचय देते हो ना, क्या नाम है आपका, सर हाँ प्रमोद, आपसे किसी ने पूछा आप कौन, आपने तुरंत बोला एडवोकेट प्रमोद फ्रॉम इलाहाबाद प्रयागराज कह दीजिए अब सरकार ने नाम बदल दिया है। आपका नाम? वो दुखी है, मैंने उनसे नहीं पूछा। सर बताइए आपका नाम। सर मयंक, एडवोकेट मयंक फ्रॉम हाँ बिहार। कौन से जगह? वेरी गुड। तो वहां के तो लोग बड़े दिमागी होते हैं। मधुबनी पेंटिंग सुना होगा आपने, फील गुड। आई मेट अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट मैजिस्ट्रेट वेरी रिसेंटली हु हैपेंस टू बी डिस्ट्रिक्ट मैजिस्ट्रेट ऑफ माय एरिया एंड ही इज फ्रॉम मधुबनी, प्रणव कुमार। सो I was talking to him regarding this education. I said that the education which is imparted in your area or in this particular territory, which is my territory also, I'm not happy with it. I want to do something. So I was sharing my plans and ideas with him. He was very reciprocative, very supportive. He said, yes, karna chahiye sir, jarur karna chahiye. Let us come to the point. I said, the way orders are written, similarly sections are written. ध्यान से पकड़ लो मेरी बात जो मैं बोल रहा हूं, तुम्हारी सारी समस्या ही समाप्त हो जाएगी। तुमने कभी ध्यान से देखा? नहीं देखा, मेरे से पूछो ना। तुमने पढ़ लिया? इट्स आवर जनरल टेंडेंसी, वी आर नेवर इनक्विजिटिव, वी नेवर इंक्वायर, वी नेवर इन्वेस्टिगेट, दो इट इज रिटन इन आवर फंडामेंटल ड्यूटी दैट वी मस्ट डेवलप साइंटिफिक टेम्पर। जैसे हम प्रभावित हो जाते, कोई संस्था छाप देती है बहुत सारे फोटोग्राफ, तो हम प्रभावित हो जाते कि जरूर ये संस्था बहुत अच्छी होगी। बट क्या तुम्हें इस बात का ज्ञान है ये फोटो छपा कैसे? 99% लोगों को ये ज्ञान नहीं है, बट मैं कितनों को घूम घूम के बताता रहूंगा। मेरा ये काम नहीं है, मेरा काम पढ़ाना है, मैं पढ़ा रहा हूं, बट आपको बता रहा हूं, यू शुड इन्वेस्टिगेट, you should inquire, you should inform yourself what is the truth. The truth is far different, but it's not so easy. So I said there is similar arrangement. Bahut similar arrangement hai. Kaise hai? Dekhte hain, chaliye aaiye, aate. Maine kaha pehle jaate ho kahin, maine abhi मयंक जी से नाम पूछा, प्रमोद जी से नाम पूछा, आप अपना नाम बता, तो ऐसे ही सिविल प्रोसीजर कोड अपना परिचय देगा, देखो भाई मैं ये, मैं वो, मैं इसमें इनफोर्स हुआ, इसमें मेरा जन्म हुआ, मैं यहाँ यहाँ लागू होता हूँ, जो भी ये बता दिया, खत्म, सेक्शन वन हो गया खत्म। दिस इज हाउ इट इज रिटन। किसी भी एक्ट में पढ़ना, आप सबसे पहले आप अपना परिचय देते हो। कहीं जाते हो नहीं बोलते हो, किसी से हाथ मिलाया तुरंत अपना नाम बोला, ऐसे ही सीपीसी भी हाथ मिलाए आपसे नाम बोला। सेक्शन वन में क्या लिखा है जरा बताओ, हाथ मिलाओ सीपीसी से। हाँ जी, हाँ लिखा क्या है पढ़ो ना। दिस एक्ट में बी साइटेड एज सिविल प्रोसीजर कोड 1900। परिचय दे दिया, अपना नाम बता दिया, रटना नहीं है। कहीं जाते पहले अपना नाम ही बताते। आप करो मैं रटूंगा बैठ के, सेक्शन वन के सब सेक्शन वन में क्या लिखा है, क्यों रट रहे हो यार? तो अगला सवाल होगा आपसे, हैव यू स्टडीड इन एएलयू? नो, आई हैव स्टडीड इन सम अदर एलयू, so those LU do not teach this, so that's not my problem, I teach it. Ambition Law University will teach you all this basics, it's basic. कहीं जाते हैं पहले अपना नाम बताते हैं। मैंने नहीं बताया इसलिए कि मैं परिचय करने नहीं आया था आपसे, मैं पढ़ाने आया था, बट सीपीसी आपसे परिचय कर रहा है, हाथ मिला रहा है, बता रहा है दिस एक्ट में बी साइटेड एज सिविल प्रोसीजर कोड 1908। नहीं, अगला क्या लिखा? shall come into force from 1st January 1909. अब रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव ऑपरेशन तो जनरली करते नहीं है, प्रोस्पेक्टिव ही करते. देखो दिमाग को थोड़ा लगाओ. तो लिखा 1909 के पहली तारीख से इसको. अगला क्या लिखा? इट एक्सटेंड्स टू होल इंडिया. ये पूरे भारत में लागू होगा, बट यहां यहां तो तुम्हें रटना नहीं है. सेक्शन वन इज इंट्रोडक्टरी सेक्शन, सेक्शन टू इज डेफिनेशनल सेक्शन. देखो हर एक्ट में सेक्शन टू डेफिनेशनल सेक्शन होता है, ध्यान रखना. सीआरपीसी हो, सीपीसी हो, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हो. इज दिस क्लियर? अब यहां भी लिखा. अब देखो तुम कहोगे कि सेक्शन टू में देखो जी इतनी बातें इन्होंने लिख दी, हाउ टू रिमेंबर दिस? दिस वॉज माई प्रॉब्लम. आई टेल यू हाउ टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम. थोड़ा ग्लिम्स तो दे दें आप कहोगे नहीं तो मुझे याद ही नहीं रहेगा सर. ये तो सेक्शन टू, हाउ मेनी वर्ड्स आर रिटन? टेल मी हाउ मेनी वर्ड्स आर रिटन. कितने शब्द लिखे हैं सेक्शन टू में? अरे जल्दी बताओ. 20. आपने कहा 20. हाउ कैन आई रिमेंबर दिस? 20 इन सेक्शन टू, देयर विल बी मेनी प्रोविजंस इन मेनी सेक्शंस. मैं कैसे याद कर लूंगा? इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट. मैं कहूंगा इट्स नॉट डिफिकल्ट, इट्स वेरी इजी. क्या है फॉर्मूला? विल यू टेल मी? फॉर्मूला इज अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर. आप जितने शब्द का डेफिनेशन है उतने शब्द कहीं जंबल करके लिख दो. एक एक्सरसाइज करो ना, एक्टिविटी करते ना. स्कूल में बहुत कराया जाता है बट कॉलेज में एक्टिविटी बदल जाती है. बट यहां एक्टिविटी आप करना, मैं आपको बताऊंगा तरीका हाउ टू डू इट, बट करना आपको पड़ेगा. एक्टिविटी कराना है. ऐसी ऐसी एक्टिविटी बहुत सारी हम लोग करेंगे और करवाएंगे आपसे. आपको एक एक्टिविटी का पेज दे दिया और आपसे कहा यही करो भैया, लो इतने वर्ड्स हैं, 20 वर्ड्स, वट एवर, यू हैव टू अरेंज देम इन एन ऑर्डर. करो. क्लियर करके देखो. अभी सबसे पहले अल्फाबेट में ए से कोई वर्ड है या नो? बी से कोई वर्ड है? नो. सी से स्टार्ट होता है तो पहले वो लिखा. दूसरा डी से आ गया तो सेकंड में वो लिखा. कुछ पढ़ने का नहीं है, मैं हिंट दे रहा हूं अभी. देखो मुझे तो याद करने के बहुत सारे तरीके, जैसे मैंने याद कर लिया सेक्शन टू, सब सेक्शन टू मैंने ऐसे भी याद किया. 2 + 2 = 4, फोर्थ अल्फाबेट इज डी, डी से डिक्री. तो मैं तो ऐसे भी याद कर लेता हूँ. आपकी मर्जी, आप कैसे याद करते हो. सेक्शन टू, सब सेक्शन वन, 2 + 1, 3, 3 से सी, सी फॉर कोड. मैं तो ऐसे भी याद करता हूँ. मेरे को आदत है मैथमेटिक्स यूज करने की, बिकॉज आई हैव बीन स्टूडेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स थ्रू आउट माई लाइफ. आई डू इट क्वाइट ऑफन. मेरे लिए बहुत ईजी है, किसी को डिफिकल्ट लगता हो मत करना, बट मेरे लिए बहुत आसान है. मैं ऐसे मैथमेटिक्स बहुत सारे बनाता हूं, डिफरेंट सब्जेक्ट्स का भी बना सकते हैं. जैसे मुझे याद करना है रिव्यू कहाँ है, तो मैं याद करूंगा सीआरपीसी में 362, 3 + 6 + 2, सीपीसी में ऑर्डर 47, 4 + 7, ये भी 11. अच्छा जी ये बताओ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में कहाँ 1 + 3 + 7 एंड ऑल कम टू. तो मुझे तो याद हो गया, अब आपको हुआ नहीं हुआ देखो. मेरे को तो मजा आता है, आई लव इट. हर का अपना अपना कॉम्पिटेंस होता है, अपनी अपनी कैपेसिटी होती है. आपको यदि लगता हो मजा आ रहा है इसमें तो करो ऐसा. इफ यू डू नॉट लाइक इट डोंट डू इट, इट्स योर चॉइस, नॉट मैंडेटरी. मेरे को अच्छा लगता है, आई डू इट क्वाइट ऑफन. क्लियर? समझ में आ रहा है? सब 11 है, देख लो, ऑल एड अप टू 11 एंड ऑल आर रिलेटेड टू रिव्यू. दिस इज ऑर्डर 47, दिस इज सेक्शन 362, दिस इज आर्टिकल 137. ये कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन है, ये सीपीसी है, ये सीआरपीसी है, दिस इज सेक्शन 362, दिस इज ऑर्डर 47 एंड दिस इज अगेन आर्टिकल 137. Clear? Now, if you like, you can do it. If you do not like, you don't do it. So I said section 2, you can remember. Now, if I have to remember, say, oh, kuch words bahut dhyan aate exam mein. Ab main kya karta hu na, questions pehle dekhta hu, objective questions. Padhne ka tarika bhi hamara hona chahiye. I am not required to remember all definitions. That is wastage of time. I am required to remember only relevant ones. Which one are relevant? Which are generally asked in examination? Which are generally asked in examination? Question paper will tell you. So see question paper. It's so simple. Is this clear? When I see question paper, I find they ask the question, judgment kaha hai, order kaha hai, mean profit, code, decree. That is a general question. Now, I know that J is 10th alphabet of English. 10th alphabet. 10th alphabet. Aapko nahi pata, toh jaan lijiye. Ye bahut jagah kaam aayega. E, jo, T. 5th, 10th, 15th. 20, 25. E, jo, T rule. आपको variety of subjects का ध्यान होना चाहिए. एक चीज पढ़ने से कभी ज्ञानी नहीं बन पाऊंगे. अब ये जिसने पढ़ा होगा उसके लिए तो आसान है. वो तो याद कर लेगा J जो है 10th alphabet है. तो J से कोई 210 में word लिखा है. कोई ना कोई वर्ड लिखा है. मेरे को इतना याद है. मैं याद नहीं कर रहा हूं. दिस इज लॉजिक. सी जे इज 10th. अब देखो 210 में जे से कोई वर्ड लिखा है नहीं लिखा. बताना नहीं है तुम्हें लिखा है नहीं लिखा. यू टेल मी ओनली दिस. लिखा है. नाउ आई नो जजमेंट इज ए वर्ड इन सीआरपी सीपीसी. एवरीबडी नोज. नाउ देर आर टू वर्ड्स, जजमेंट डेटर एंड जजमेंट. अब मैं भूल गया एग्जाम.